Hey guys, Vikram Parolkar from our Test Suite Specialist team here. And today we're going to be talking about how to test ServiceNow as the application under test. We're going to investigate three requirements. First, bulk task management. Second, incident creation. And third, handling attachments and the ability for a user to download them. Let's take a look at our bulk task management requirement. Under it, we can see we have three different test cases. I can view all my test cases on the Test Case tab and sort by the different tags allocated to each one. Here we see all six. If I dive into a specific test case, I can view the manual steps behind the test case that might have been defined by the tester user, and whether or not it has an automation. Let's dive into automation creation. This is UiPath Studio. On the left-hand side, we have our activities pane where we can teach the robot how to actually interact with an application. For ease of use to interact with the user interface of an application, we have this app web recorder. When I enter recording mode, as I hover over different objects in my ServiceNow application, you'll see that I have the ability to interact with them. If I want to, for example, record a click, it will search for that item and record the action. When interacting with an application, UiPath uses multiple targeting mechanisms, accessing the underlying data like most other applications do, a fuzzy version of that so it doesn't have to be an exact match, and as a fallback text and image-based automation. All of these methods are used simultaneously to ensure the most robust interaction with a specific UI element. In situations where it's needed, variables can be used to replace specific objects, allowing the developer to interact with the application dynamically. In addition, if it's impossible to uniquely identify a specific target, users are able to add anchors that allow the robot to interact with a specific UI element the same way a human might, looking for specific row identifiers or column identifiers. Finally, when dealing with tables, UiPath also has a table extraction feature that allows you to quickly indicate a table and retrieve all of the information from it. In situations where there's a next button, the table extraction wizard automatically prompts you for that, and you're able to indicate that next button as seen here. For testers that want to leverage the ServiceNow API, UiPath has a series of out-of-the-box activities that allow you to easily configure the API. All you have to do is surround the activities with a ServiceNow application scope, where you configure parameter to actually connect to the ServiceNow endpoint, and then you can simply insert the specific records or API calls that you want to configure. We have a configuration wizard where you can select the specific object. Let's say I want to work with a ticket object. It shows you the mandatory fields, and then you can add any optional fields that you want to leverage as part of your API call. Finally, let's take a look at how UiPath handles data. In our workflows, data can come from a variety of sources. UiPath has database activities that allows us to connect to database to retrieve data. In addition, we have email activities that allows us to download attachments that is used in this scenario here to create an incident ticket from email. Finally, any of our test cases, we're able to add test data to them. Test data can be from an existing data source, a file, or even UiPath's own data service. Once data is uploaded to a specific test case, when it's executed, we'll be able to see it execute on multiple different variations. Returning to Test Manager, let's navigate to the Test Sets tab and see our ServiceNow test set. We can define the various test cases. We see six of them here, and we can choose to execute either manually or automated. Let's go ahead and start the automated execution. Our robot will pop up and navigate through six different scenarios. Notice that each scenario does not need to be executed in order because each scenario is independently defined. In Test Manager, you'll be able to view all of the automated results. Each test case will have an assertion, logs, execution details, and the affected requirements. If we jump into a requirement, you'll see all of the test cases and the latest result for each test case. Diving into one of those test cases, here you can see the screenshots for the assertions, again the logs, and if needed, you can create defects directly from Test Manager. Defects will be created in the third-party defect management solution. Here we see Azure DevOps. In Azure DevOps, you can see all of the log information and the attachments available for the developers to evaluate the defect. This concludes our demo of ServiceNow test automation. Till next time, bye.